Chapman, after the fire, did you receive notice from the landlord to vacate the premises on Austin Avenue? After the fire, yes. How long after the fire? 2 or 3 months. When did you vacate? I believe it was in December. When did you move into the new quarters? In December. When did you start looking around for new quarters? In November, I think. Was it before or after you received the notice to vacate? I don't remember, just when I got the notice. Did you have any discussion with anybody after the fire about the maintenance of the equipment to keep it from rusting? I talked to Mr. Cole. Mr. Cole is from Cole Insurance Agency. Is that right? That's right. How long after the fire did you talk with Mr. Cole? I don't recall. Was it days or weeks? It had to be days. Who else was present at that conversation? I think it was over the phone. What did Mr. Cole tell you about maintenance? He told me to oil down all the equipment. Did he tell you why? I guess it was to inhibit rusting. Did you have all the equipment oiled? I did it myself immediately. And that was within a week after the fire? It was less than that. What did you do with the equipment that was in there at the time of the fire? We couldn't do anything with it. Mr. Cole said he didn't want us to move it. Was it finally moved? Yes. When? In December. Where was it moved? It was moved to our new quarters. In Bellwood? That's right. Is any of the equipment in use right now? Yes, it is. How much of it? Oh, 4 or 5 pieces. What pieces? It depends upon what you are referring to. Well, any of the equipment that was in the fire? Maybe half of it. What did you have to do to this equipment to get it back in use? We had to clean it and replace some parts. It is functional, but it is not in good condition. And what? Faster. Mr. Chapman, after the fire, did you receive notice from the landlord to vacate the premises on Austin Avenue? After the fire, yes. How long after the fire? 2 or 3 months. When did you vacate? I believe it was in December. When did you move into the new quarters? In December. When did you start looking around for new quarters? In November, I think. Was it before or after you received the notice to vacate? I don't remember just when I got the notice. Did you have any discussion with anybody about the fire, about the maintenance of the equipment to keep it from rusting? I talked to Mr. Cole. Mr. Cole is from Cole Insurance Agency. Is that right? That's right. How long after the fire did you talk with Mr. Cole? I don't recall. Was it days or weeks? It had to be days. Who else was present at that conversation? I think it was over the phone. What did Mr. Cole tell you about maintenance? He told me to oil down all the equipment. Did he tell you why? I guess it was to inhibit rusting. Did you have all the equipment oiled? I did it myself immediately. And that was within a week after the fire. It was less than that. What did you do with the equipment that was in there at the time of the fire? We couldn't do anything with it. Mr. Cole said he didn't want us to move it. Was it finally moved? Yes. When? In December. Where was it moved? It was moved to our new quarters. In Bellwood? That's right. Is any of the equipment in use right now? Yes, it is. How much of it? Oh, 4 or 5 pieces. What pieces? It depends upon what you are referring to. Well, any of the equipment that was in the fire? Maybe half of it. What did you have to do to this equipment to get it back in use? We had to clean it and replace some parts. It is functional, but it is not in good condition.
Okay, one more time on this one.
Mr. Chapman, after the fire, did you receive notice from the landlord to vacate the premises on Austin Avenue? After the fire, yes. How long after the fire? 2 or 3 months. When did you vacate? I believe it was in December. When did you move into the new quarters? In December. When did you start looking around for new quarters? In November, I think. Was it before or after you received the notice to vacate? I don't remember just when I got the notice. Did you have any discussion with anybody after the fire about the maintenance of the equipment to keep it from rusting? I talked to Mr. Cole. Mr. Cole is from Cole Insurance Agency. Is that right? That's right. How long after the fire did you talk with Mr. Cole? I don't recall. Was it days or weeks? It had to be days. Who else was present at that conversation? I think it was over the phone. What did Mr. Cole tell you about maintenance? He told me to oil down all the equipment. Did he tell you why? I guess it was to inhibit rusting. Did you have all the equipment oiled? I did it myself immediately. And that was within a week after the fire. It was less than that. What did you do with the equipment that was in there at the time of the fire? We couldn't do anything with it. Mr. Cole said he didn't want us to move it. Was it finally moved? Yes. When? In December. Where was it moved? It was moved to our new quarters. In Bellwood? That's right. Is any of the equipment in use right now? Yes, it is. How much of it? Oh, 4 or 5 pieces. What pieces? It depends upon what you are referring to. Well, any of the equipment that was in the fire? Maybe half of it. What did you have to do to this equipment to get it back in use? We had to clean it and replace some parts. It is functional, but it is not in good condition. Did you have your own people clean the equipment and repair it? Or did you call in somebody else? Our people did most of the work, but we bought some new parts and had some repaired. By outside sources? I think so. What pieces were repaired by outside sources? I am not sure. but an outside electrician worked on all of the electrical parts. What is his name? Mike Alexander. Does he go by that name as a company? Well, he has his own repair shop. Do you have an accounting for the cost of putting each machine in working order? No. Do you have an accounting for the cost of putting all of the equipment back in running condition? No. So you can't tell from your records how much it cost you to put the equipment in working order? I think we could come up with the cost of the work done by outside help, but I don't think there is a separate record of the time put in by our employees. What about the parts? We would have bills for the parts. What about the parts that you had on hand as opposed to the parts that you ordered? I think we can get that information. What about the other equipment that has not been put back into use? Where is that? It is at our plant in Bellwood. Is it still oiled? Yes. Did the oil inhibit the rust? I don't think so. The rust had already set in. Let's try that one again. Did you have your own people clean the equipment and repair it, or did you call in somebody else? Our people did most of the work, but we bought some new parts and had some repaired. By outside sources? I think so. What pieces were repaired by outside sources? I am not sure. But an outside electrician worked on all of the electrical parts. What is his name? Mike Alexander. Does he go by that name as a company? Well, he has his own repair shop. Do you have an accounting for the cost of putting each machine in working order? No. Do you have an accounting for the cost of putting all of the equipment back in running condition? No. So you can't tell from your records how much it cost you to put the equipment in working order? I think we could come up with the cost of the work done by outside help, but I don't think there is a separate record of the time put in by our employees. What about the parts? We would have bills for the parts. What about the parts that you had on hand as opposed to the parts that you ordered? I think we can get that information. Okay, one more time on this one. Did you have your own people clean the equipment and repair it, or did you call in somebody else? Our people did most of the work, but we bought some new parts and had some repaired. By outside sources? I think so. What pieces were repaired by outside sources? I am not sure. But an outside electrician worked on all of the electrical parts. What is his name? Mike Alexander. Does he go by that name as a company? Well, he has his own repair shop. Do you have an accounting for the cost of putting each machine in working order? No. Do you have an accounting for the cost of putting all of the equipment back in running condition? No. So you can't tell from your records how much it cost you to put that equipment in working order, I think we could come up with the cost of the work done by outside help, but I don't think there is a separate record of the time put in by our employees. What about the parts? We would have bills for the parts. What about the parts that you had on hand as opposed to the parts that you ordered? I think we can get that information. What about the other equipment that has not been put back into use? Where is that? It is at our plant in Bellwood. Is it still oiled? Yes. Did the oil inhibit the rust? I don't think so. The rust had already set in. Here we go. Now, you saw the defendant when he was arrested, didn't you? Yes. And you saw him in the police court? Yes. And you have seen him outside in the corridor the last 2 or 3 weeks, haven't you? Yes. Now, on this day in question, was there any light burning in this hallway? No. Are there any windows in this hallway? Yes, two. Where are those windows located with respect to the door leading into the kitchen of your apartment? Well, they are at the side. About how far away? Well, about 2 feet. And where is the other window? It is about 2 feet away from the parlor. Now, when these men or man knocked up this door, what was the first thing that you did? I just kept quiet. I know that, but what did you do after that? When they kept continually knocking, I went to the window and I looked out. How did they continue to knock before you went to this window in the bedroom, which leads into the hallway, after they knocked about 4 or 5 times? How long did that take, approximately? Not quite a minute. Was there anybody living in the apartment next door to you? No, there wasn't. Was that an empty apartment? Yes. Now, when you went to the bedroom, was the window leading into the hallway open or shut? It was partly open. It was not locked? No, it was not. Now, you opened that very quietly, I assume. Is that correct? No, I didn't open it. It was partly open so that I could see through. How high from the ground is that window? Well, about 3 feet or so. That is the lowest part of the window. The window is about 3.5 feet from the ground. Yes. About how large was it? Was it as large as one of these courtroom windows? Not quite as long, about 3/4 as long as that. As the whole window? There are 2 halves to that window. Was your window bigger than any of those halves? First part of the window and about 1/4. Now, as I said, there are 2 parts to that window. It is divided into 2 parts, an upper and a lower part. Do you mean the whole window? That window is about 8 feet high, I would say. I do not mean the whole window. Was your window as long as that? No. Was the window as large as one of those halves? No. I would say it was about 5 feet. About 5 feet, well, 5, whatever you call it. Now, at that time, you say, you saw a man with some papers under his arm? Yes. Now, the man you saw at that time, was that the defendant? Yes. Are you sure of that? Yes. There is no question in your mind about it? No. How was he dressed at the time? Well, I didn't take notice of it. Did you notice the color of the suit that this man wore, whose face you claimed you observed? No. I did not. Did you notice what kind of a hat he was wearing, if any? I don't think, I am not sure. I won't state it. You did not observe that? No, I did not. Can you tell us what the height of the man was that you observed in the hallway at that time as he appeared to you from your point of observation? About 5'8". About 5'8". Now, is there anything about the features of this man that made an impression on your mind at that time? Don't look at him now. No, there was nothing outstanding about his appearance that made any impression on you at all? No. And by the way, you had never seen this man before, had you? No, I did not. Now, you say that you observed another man with him at that time? I did not say that. One twenty. All the time you were in the employ of this company, were you in the same department as you were on June 5? I was not, no. How long had you been in that department? Well, I believe almost a year. And the kind of work you did in that department was to make investigations in connection with matters pertaining to customers of the company? Yes, sir. In this particular case, you went up there with reference to an appliance, a balance due on an electric iron. Is that not so? Yes, sir. When you went in the place, who was there? Mrs. Stone was there. She was there alone, wasn't she? Yes, sir. What room did you go in? I first went into the dining room. It is a small apartment. How long were you in that room? Maybe a second. Then where did you go? I went into the bedroom while she went into the kitchen to get me the iron. You were in the bedroom alone while she went into some other room, the kitchen or somewhere? Yes, sir. Did you have any conversation with her? I did not know. Didn't you say anything to her at all? I asked her to let me see the iron in order to get the name of it, in order to make a report to cover myself that I had interviewed the woman. You say you asked to see the iron for what purpose? To get the name of the iron and make a record of it. You did not make any record? I did so. I put it up in the left-hand corner of my report. That is my own handwriting on there. Also the report that she gave to me. Then you left, I suppose? I did leave, yes, sir. Was that the last place you went to that day? That was my last call, yes. The next time you heard anything about this matter was on Monday morning. You saw your chief at that time? Monday morning, yes. And she told you that Mrs. Stone had communicated with the company and said that a collector who was there had taken a diamond ring, had stole a diamond ring, yes. Did she ask you if you remembered going to that place? The first word she said to me, did you make this call Friday? And I said yes. That was in the morning when you were there on Monday. That was in the morning at 9 o'clock. Yes, sir. And then on Tuesday when you came in, she asked you to wait. Is that right? Monday morning, first she communicated with someone on the phone. Never mind about communicating. Anyway, she sent you out on Monday and you went around and did your work all day. That is true, isn't it? Yes, it is true. On Tuesday, you waited in the office. She told me to remain there, yes. About 9:30 or 10, two detectives came in, yes, sir. Did they tell you that Mrs. Stone, at that time, had made a complaint to the police about the ring being stolen? Yes, sir. Who had told you, the chief, the previous day? She told you the previous day. You say the detective put his hand on your shoulder and said you were under arrest. Is that right? Yes, sir. 110, two voice. What is your name, Sam? Where do you live? In New York City. How long have you lived in this city? Approximately 10 years. Where did you live before that time? Long Island. What is your business? I am a salesman. By whom are you employed? By the defendant in this case. Where is his place of business? Uptown Manhattan. Are you acquainted with the plaintiff in this action? Yes, sir, I am. Have you been subpoenaed to come here? Yes, sir. And you have been called as a witness on behalf of the defendant? Yes, sir, I have. How old are you at the present time? I am 30 years of age. Do you remember the day this accident happened? Yes, sir. I remember the date very well. What kind of a car was